with you in the office this morning. Tell us what you learned and when.
You too. Well, the first bombing was the Soros bombing, right? Receiving the bomb on Monday. And basically, everybody held their breath. To use a frightening analogy, for me, it reminded me of when the first plane hit the World Trade Center 9/11. And you said, well, maybe it's just an aviation accident. And then the second plane hit. The Soros receipt of the bomb, people investigated, et cetera, but we really didn't know what it meant. Last night, about 1 o'clock in the morning, the Secret Service notified the state of police that the residents of the Clintons had intercepted a bomb. And that's when we knew it wasn't just one situation. This was probably going to be a pattern. We worked on it last night with the state police and the Secret Service, who were magnificent, and JTTF. I went past the Clintons' residence at 4:30 to speak to the Secret Service this morning, and everything was in order. But at that point, you knew, I felt, there was going to be more to come. And then, as we know, you had the Obamas, you had the CNN bomb, et cetera. So the first hope was it was a one-off. It was just George Soros, and that was terrible. But obviously, this pattern is even much, much worse.
Well, thank God nobody was hurt. And now they're trying to assess whether these bombs were functional. And that means you've got to get the guy or the people who were involved with it, because there could be more. Or if it was just meant to look like something that could have been functional, and that's bad enough, and then they go find them. So then you have the larger context that we're all struggling with here, which is maybe it had nothing to do with our political environment. But even if it did have nothing to do with it, even though that'd be one hell of a coincidence, because everyone targeted is somebody that the president targets, it's still a moment for us to, out of fear, look around at what's going on. Everyone I talk to is all about both sides, both sides, both sides. When it comes to Republicans, they will not call out the president. And he had his opportunity tonight. He is who he is. Let's leave him to the side. Why do you tell my audience tonight that they should have hope that anything better can come from their political dialogue?
Well, look, first, let's hit the first part of your question first. The first step is the investigation, the manhunt, JTTF, fingerprints, videotapes, find out who did it. The next step is secure the public. We brought out more National Guard, more state police, crossings, et cetera, so people feel secure. The third step is what you're now talking about. Let's look at what really happened. People call this domestic terrorism. I think we need a new word. Terrorism we normally equate with a tension between this nation and another nation. Even domestic terrorism is normally referred to as a lone wolf operating within this country, but in the interest of a foreign country. That's not what this is. This is political terrorism. This is American terrorism. This is red versus blue terrorism. And that we have never seen before. I think this president certainly missed an opportunity tonight. An opportunity for himself and a responsibility for the country. He could have really stepped up and been the leader that the people want him to be. He could have been the president of the United States. Michael Youssef wrote a book, The Leadership Moment, that says sometimes leadership comes when the moment presents itself. He had that moment today. He missed that moment. And as a matter of fact, I believe he reinforced the negative. If you listen to his words, there's sharp divides, an important election, days away, the media is to blame. It's almost as if he can't bring himself to admit his error, and he can't take his foot off the gas. He wants to fire up right. his base for the election. That's what this is. Let's be right. honest. He needs a big turnout. He doesn't want to lose the Congress. He wants to fire up his base, and he's firing up his base. The lesson here is When you spread that much hate, that much venom, mob, chaos, bad people, there are people who are affected by that. We're emotional beings. And in this society, you can download from the internet how to build the bomb. And when you are spreading that hate, it's almost inevitable that someone or some group is going to feed off it. Now, I just listened to your great debate. Step one is bring down the tone. Don't argue about it. Bring down the tone. If he won't bring down the tone, then the other leaders have to bring down the tone. And I don't believe he will. You can have a disagreement. You can have a forceful disagreement. But it's not ad hominem. It's not mean. It's not do or die. It's not you have to be punished. Otherwise, Chris,
I hear you about
this
that.
Does not stop. This does not stop. This is a terrorism
that's the fear.
That is more frightening than any other terrorism we've seen. Well, yeah, but right. There's a responsibility
Big Brother,
for
thank you
all
very much.
Leaders, not just the president. Are you cutting
Understood,
me off, little brother?
And that's as true as anything else. I am. I've got to get the break, Governor, but thank you very much. I'll make it up to you. Thank you for being on the show. I appreciate it, and thank God you and yours were okay today.
I'm glad you're safe and tell Jeff Zucker he did a great job the way CNN handled this today.